Good morning, dear students. I hope you all are fit and fine at home. Dear students, as we know, we have started block 13 and first lesson plan is already done. The borders of our state, right? And I hope you all have completed the homework also. Student, today we are going to start second lesson plan of block 13. And what is the topic for today's topic? Today's class, food in our state. And what will be the keywords for today's class? Recipe, ingredient, dish, occasion. What is the meaning of recipe? The steps to prepare a food, ingredients, the substances and the things which we need to prepare a special kind of dish. Dish, a special kind of food, occasion, the particular event. And the resources for today's class, political map of India, content book, notebook and workbook, students. And our agenda, as usual, first we will go for the questioning part, then discussion, after then activity, then worksheet, and at last we will move for the homework part, student. Yes, students, as you know, we eat different kinds of food, right? Okay, now think about the food which is widely eaten in your state. Yes, think about it, which food is eaten in your state? In my state, which dish is widely eaten? This is churma. And one more dish that I have seen somewhere, means in Gujarat when I went there, because I spent a lot of time there, that is poha. These are some special dishes which are eaten here. One churma is eaten in my state and poha that is eaten in Gujarat. And I will show you these dishes in the activity part, students. So students, what is our today's aim? Our today's aim is to connect some geographical and cultural aspect of the state to food. Means, hum kis cheez ko connect karein? To connect some geographical. Geographical means which kind of the means feature of that part of the state, and the cultural aspect of the state to food. Food ke saath hum un cheezon ko connect karenge, right? Now students, move to the activity part. Yes students, now I'm going to show you my favorite dishes, that is churma and poha. Student, yes, this is the churma and I like it most. Yes, and as you know, this is very sweet and delicious dish, right? And one more I have, this also I have prepared. What is this? This is poha. So students, just now you have seen the picture of churma and poha. So today we are going to discuss about the churma. So today we will see what one particular dish can tell us about our state. Means हमें एक particular जो dish है हमारे state के बारे में हमें वो क्या बताती, right students? Yes students, now have a look on this. This is the picture of the churma and some ingredients are also written on this. Yes, read it very carefully. Yes students, have a look on it carefully. Yes, now have a look on this map of India also. As on this map, the crops which are grown on large scale in India are indicated, right, through the color, and the names are also mentioned in the on the scale. So have a look on this map also, students. Student, you have seen the picture of churma, right? Okay, now tell me which is the main ingredient that is used in churma, right? Think about it, right? The wheat flour, and what else is used here? Ghee and bura, the sweet, you can say sugar and sweet, and the jaggery, gur. These things are the main ingredients to make this churma, right students? So the most important ingredient is wheat flour. And from where do we get wheat flour? Right, from the wheat. And as you have seen the map of India, where wheat is grown widely, right? The wheat is grown, as you have seen on the map of the India, it is grown on large scale in India, in Haryana, Punjab, Uttar Pradesh and in Madhya Pradesh, right students? So because all the ingredients are easily available, so this is the favorite dish of that area. And ghee, bura, and like the sweet and gur, or these things are also used, right? Ghee and butters also, these things are easily available to the people because they are farming the, they are rearing the animals also. Animals ko rakte hai, like cows and buffaloes ko rakte hai. So dairy product like ghee, butter, unke paas easily available ho jata, right students? So student, my first question to you, yes, which ingredient is used a lot in this, right? The wheat flour. And wheat flour, we get the wheat flour from wheat crops, right? And second question, who do you think eats this dish? Who do you eat? Yes, कौन खाता है इस डिश को? All people, right? Children also, man, women, poor and rich, all are eating this dish, right? And the next question is it eaten for special occasion? Is this churma is eaten only on a special occasion? No, it is eaten every day means commonly it is eaten. But it is eaten always as it is easy to make and it doesn't cost a lot. Why? Because it is easy to make and the ingredients are easily available to the people. Students, which ingredient is used a lot in this churma, right? Wheat, right? Wheat flour is used and wheat is grown. Where wheat is grown? As I have shown you in the map also, it is widely grown in Kurukshetra, in Haryana, Punjab, Madhya Pradesh, right students? So, what will you do now in Haryana if we are talking about Karnal and Kurukshetra, it is widely grown. And now again look the map, look on the map, have a look on this map and find out these cities of Haryana, Kurukshetra and Karnal, where this the wheat crop is grown widely. Yes, pause the video and find out these cities in this map only. Students, my next question is who eats this dish? The churma we were talking, right? And occasion it is eaten on and which occasion this is eaten? And what does it tell us, right student? Student, this is a common dish, right? And it is eaten by all, the common people also. Why? Because this the ingredients are easily available there. The main ingredient is wheat and wheat is grown widely on this area, right students? And what does it tell us? What does this tell us about our state? So, ye jo dish hai hamari, jo ye hamari state ke bare mein kya batati hai? Because this dish is eaten widely almost all over the area, right? So this dish tells us about our state that the wheat crop is grown here on the large scale, right? So this is the common aspect which we have got from this dish, right? So student, now this is time for the horse, the higher order thinking question. So students, my question is, if the food items of two states use the same ingredients, do you think these ingredients grow in both the states? क्या जो food items हैं, दो states के food items की बात कर रहे हैं हम? Use the same ingredients, क्या same ingredients का use कर सकते हैं वो? And do you think these ingredients grow in both the states? और जो वो ingredient है वो दोनों ही states में grow किया जाता है? If we are talking about churma, right? In churma, which ingredient we use? We use wheat flour and wheat is grown in Haryana also and as well as in Punjab also, right? And Punjab mein bhi gehun se jo wheat hai, usse rotiyan banai jati, right? This can be the food items, any food items we can take, right? So there is the ingredients wheat, it is grown in both the states as well as in Punjab and in Haryana and it is used in the food items also. So as students, not only from the wheat we can make the churma, hum sirf wheat se churma nahi bana sakte, we can use the bajra, the millet also we can use, right? And this millet, this crop is also grown in Haryana and in Punjab and in other states of India also. This is grown on large scale and this is the kharif fasal. Yes students, and we can make with this millet, bajra, the khichdi also, right students? So there are many crops which are grown in India. At last student, to summarize today's learning, what is our aim? As our aim was to connect some geographical and cultural aspects of the state to food, right? So to summarize our today's learning, now we are going to read the chapter. Open page number 27 of your content book, States of India. Now we are going to read about Kerala. Kerala is a state in southern India. It is near the Arabian Sea. A lot of dishes here includes fish and rice. Kerala is famous for spices like pepper. People here speak Malayalam, English and other languages. Kerala has beautiful forests and mountains. Thiruvananthapuram is the capital city of Kerala. Yes, Kerala is situated in the southern part of India and it is near the Arabian Sea. And a lot of dishes here includes fish and rice. So fish and rice, they include in their dish, as we talked about, means the things which are easily available on their place, they are using in their food also. So fish and rice, it is easily available to to the people who they are living in Kerala, so they includes these things. And Kerala is famous for the spices like pepper. And which language is spoken here? The Malayalam and English also, and many other languages are also spoken here. And it has beautiful forests and mountains. And what is the name of the capital of Kerala? Thiruvananthapuram. Now move to the next page, page number 28. Manipur. Manipur is a state in eastern India. Manipur has many mountains and lakes. Loktok is a large and beautiful lake in the state. A lot of dishes in Manipur are made from rice, vegetable and fish. Some people speak Matilon, but many other languages are spoken too. The capital of Manipur is the large city of Imphal. This student, Manipur is situated in the eastern part of India and it has many mountains and lakes. And what is the name of the beautiful lake here? The Loktok. Right, students, and the capital city of Manipur is Imphal. Next is Himachal Pradesh. Himachal Pradesh is a state in northern India. It is in the Himalayas and has snowy mountains. The common food items of Himachal Pradesh are vegetables, wheat, meat and rice. The people of Himachal Pradesh speak Hindi. Shimla is the capital city of state. As you know, Himachal Pradesh, it falls in the northern part of India and Himalaya has the snowy mountains. और वहाँ का क्लाइमेट भी कैसा होगा? कोल्ड होता है. एंड द कॉमन फूड फूड आइटम्स ऑफ हिमाचल प्रदेश आर वेजिटेबल, व्हीट, मीट एंड राइस. एंड द कैपिटल सिटी ऑफ हिमाचल प्रदेश इज शिमला. नाउ मूव टू द नेक्स्ट पेज, पेज नंबर 29. महाराष्ट्र. महाराष्ट्र इज अ स्टेट इन वेस्टर्न इंडिया लाइक केरला. इट इज नियर द अरेबियन सी. इट इज ऑल्सो सिचुएटेड नियर द अरेबियन सी. एंड इट हैज मैनी ब्यूटिफुल माउंटेन्स विच पीपल गो टू फॉर फन. Many dishes in Maharashtra are made from rice, jowar and wheat. The people of Maharashtra speak Marathi and other languages. Mumbai is the largest city and the capital city of the state. So what is the capital of Mumbai? Mumbai is the, Maharashtra. Mumbai is the capital city of Maharashtra. And the dish which is eaten here, that is made from jowar and wheat and rice. And beautiful mountains are also there and people go there for fun. So students, this was all about our today's class. Student, now move to the application part. You will do S2 on page number 26 in your workbook. You will complete your S2 that is given in your workbook and it must be completed within 10 minutes. Yes, students, now open page number 26 of your workbook. Student, open page number 26. Question number 1. Food on the map, draw a fish to show from where you think the people of Kerala will find fish to eat. Means आपको यहाँ पर fish draw करने हैं from where the people of Kerala find the fishes. As you know, the Kerala, it is near the, it is on the shore of Arabian Sea. Arabian Sea के पास में, so it is clear to you what would be the answer. Many dishes in Manipur use rice. What does this tell us about Manipur? As I told you in the discussion part also, means if they use rice in their dishes, so what does this thing tell us about Manipur? Question number 3. The table shows dishes made in two states. Circle the names of the ingredients that you think grows in both the states. State 1 and state 2, jowar, bread, vegetable and rice, chicken, curry and rice, mango juice. And state 2, coconut rice, lemon rice, milk, halwa, mutton fry. So you will complete this workbook.
Now it is time for the homework. What is your today's homework? You will practice question number 4, 5 and 6. That is given on page number 30 in your content book. So I hope you all have enjoyed your today's class, the Churmain, the Poha. I hope so. And thank you. Have a nice day and be ready for the next class also. And the resources for next class, content book, notebook and workbook.